Hi, this is Ben Jones. We're in Hyde Park. It is Hard Rock calling. The weather is still good. And, well, today the Americans have taken over. So thank God for James Morrison. Good to see you.
Yeah, English, keeping it
How
strong
are you?
In England. Yeah, good, actually. Yeah,
I've got to tell you, I was watching. I haven't even been out to the main stage yet. I'm working my ass off here, man. I'm working my ass off. But I saw you from the big screen we got here. And you look like you were having the time of your life.
Yeah, man. Well, I enjoy it. I think, you know, especially when it's not your crowd and it's such a big show, I try not to get too nervous and just go out and enjoy it. They weren't my crowd in the beginning. It took a while to get them going. But once I got them going, it was good. Yeah.
Do you think most of them, I mean, let's be honest, 99.9% of them are here for Springsteen?
Totally, of course. You can totally feel it as well. I mean, they're an older audience, you know. He's got a lot of fans from a while back, from the 70s. So, yeah, but it was good. It was a bit like Dad Rock audience, but, you know, I give it as much as I could give. And, I tried to, you know, I think the fact it is a rock stage, you have got to up the ante a little bit. And I tried to do that, and it worked by the end, but it was hard.
There are very few pop acts. I hope you don't mind me calling you a pop act.
No, that's not at all.
But you're a pop act, but you nailed it on a rock stage. And that is quite a tough job to do, isn't it?
Well, I've been singing a long time, you know. I've been singing a lot of different music. I've not always been, a pop writer. It's just the way that it worked out for me, the way I was placed. I didn't want to be a rock singer because it's a little bit too hard. I always want the lyrics to mean something. And a lot of the time in rock music, it's all about just getting laid or going out, you know, which is cool.
Is that why you put the leather jacket on? Suddenly you put the leather
jacket on? Well, I love leather jackets. I've always wanted a real good leather jacket, so I think perfect. Rock stage, whack it on, yeah.
Gonna wear a leather jacket and, you know, keep it real. So let's talk about the music, because you have done incredibly well.
Yeah,
we feel
good.
Like we kind of lost you a little bit, and I don't mean this in a bad way, but you kind of went over to America, and we want to keep you.
Well, to
ourselves.
Be honest, I've been doing a lot of shows, man, in England, all over, with Take That, as well as my own, as well as little tiny ones I've been doing. But yeah, you know, I'm just lucky that it's been taken off in a lot of different territories and countries that I've been able to go out there and do shows as well out there. It's a good thing. But yeah, obviously, my main places I play are in England, you know. And obviously, America's important as an artist, but I never forget where I'm from, you know. I'm not going to go all American. No, I'll go America.
Do what we like to refer to now
as
the Joss Stone. Come back 18 months and you've got James Morrison's got.
Well, I'm glad to say I saw her not so long ago, and she's definitely a Devon girl.
Good, good. When you go out to the States, what are you talking about? Are you talking about the current record, or do you get, because it's weird for us.
Well, a lot of it is to do with the old record as well, yeah, because they're only just getting to hear it. It didn't get played loads, you know, on radio. I didn't get plugged or whatever, but yeah, people know enough about it. I've got a bigger fan base out there than I did have last time. And
does that help because, you know, the collaboration with Nelly Furtado?
Definitely. I think Nelly Furtado was definitely a big part of me going out there again because, yeah, you know, she's a well-known artist in the States. And I think, you know, working with Ryan Tedder helped. But I think I'm just glad that, you know, it all worked out that way naturally. It wasn't like a big business plan to try and crack America by using American artists. It happened that way naturally. And that's what I'm glad about, you know.
Now, Ryan, for those people listening to this who don't know One Republic, Ryan is the songwriter and lead singer of One Republic.
He wrote some big songs.
I think he wrote Bleeding Love as well.
Yeah.
So, you know, one would imagine the bank manager opens the door
when Ryan Tedder walks in. Yeah.
Has he taught you much as a songwriter? I mean, you're an accomplished singer-songwriter in your own
right. Well, I think the main thing I learned from him was probably that you don't need to use that many chords. But, you know, there's a lot of songs in the R&B world that only use four chords. Like Beyonce's song is only a four-chord something. I think it's four-chord song. You know, Halo. It's not a lot of chords.
But then look at rock music. AC/DC and Status Quo have made careers out of playing the same song.
But I think it's a lot harder to pull that off nowadays because it's been done so many times. But he's got a knack for kind of using not many chords and making it sound fresh. So he's good like that.
What does live music mean to you? Here we are. We're in a field. The sun is shining. We've got, Dave Matthews on at the moment. We've got Springsteen on a little later. What's live music?
Live music is a big part of my life. I mean, to be honest, I get asked a lot, like, what do I do when I'm not working? And a lot of the time, I'd listen to music. I play music, music is my life. So it's well important. Live music brings together people from different places and races, and it kind of allows you to feel like you're free for a little while, you know, and that's what's great about it.
When you write a song, are you always writing with you in mind, or now?
I try and write with other people in mind. I'm starting to try and write less about me and about other people. I'm writing songs for other people that I care about, you know, or things that I think will help people, or I don't know. I'm a little bit of a hippie, so I, I just try and write songs that will affect people in some way. I don't know.
Have you given a song to someone else to maybe use or to release as a song? And actually thought in hindsight, damn it, that was actually really, really good. I wish I kept that for myself.
No, I don't. I mean, I think it's obvious to me when the song's right to use or not. If it's not right, then it's not right. I had a song called Baby Come Back Now, which is like stompy kind of rocky kind of bluesy thing. And Misha Paris ended up using it, covering it in the States. So that was brilliant.
How do you go about writing a song? I've been trying to play guitar for years. I've wanted to play guitar. I think if you can inject me with a talent, some people would say I have no talent at all. I mean, I have to scrape mine
from the air too, mate, you know?
Really? But I mean, I look at the guitar and I think, do you know what? Everyone looks so cool when they're playing a guitar. I just want to learn.
Well, I used to dribble quite a lot, so I wasn't always cool playing the guitar. But I've been playing since I was 13. I should be better than I am, but I always concentrated on what you're singing about emotionally and projecting your voice so that people feel what you're singing. You know, that's my main thing that I concentrate on.